It's been called the most perfect medieval fortress in Britain. Last year, it attracted nearly 2.5 million visitors. But Guy Wilson believes the Tower of London, which dominated the skyline for 800 years, has been dwarfed and suffocated by the buildings around it.
It is no longer a massive building which inspires awe and fear. It is now almost something that you see on the top of a wedding cake or a garden ornament. The whole scale has changed, so it becomes cute, pretty, interesting, but not a dominating massive building.
Rarely have London's architects and planners been so much on the defensive. Last Friday's documentary by Prince Charles didn't pull any punches. Likening the National Theatre to a nuclear power station, this modern office block in the city to a 1930s wireless set. The city's chief planner welcomes the debate, but says you can't have it both ways.
Planners are in the middle, having to try and maintain a balance between what is beautiful and aesthetically pleasing to tourists and to people who work at the Tower of London, and on the other hand, 350,000 people whose jobs depend on commuting into the city every day, and perhaps twice that number throughout the country.
But can't you accommodate those people in buildings that are more harmonious with the historical buildings?
Of course, buildings can be designed more beautifully and more harmoniously. That's not to say that they can be designed in pastiche to be copies, little copies of the Tower of London or in mock Georgian style necessarily.
Are you just anti-modern?
Absolutely not. No, I love modern architecture, a lot of modern architecture. It's a question of scale and place.
This salvo from the Tower of London comes as another proposed development threatens two more giant towers on a site opposite. The Environment Secretary has called the plans in and is now considering them. Over the years, the tower has learned to live, however reluctantly, with its new neighbours. But planners and architects may have to think twice if their heads aren't to go on the block again. John Andrew at the Tower of London, Thames News.